And welcome to the Meeting Cows podcast. I am Anna, the knitter, and these are the cows. Welcome to the episode 3, and well, welcome back to the returning viewers, and welcome to the new ones. You can find me on Instagram as the Knitting Cows 4643, on Ravelry as the Knitting Cows, and that's it. Well, this is an episode after the Edimburgh Yarn Festival. I have a haul, but we will start first with finished objects. I have finished the ankle socks with the contrasting heels and toes, which I have shown to you last time as works in progress. I love them. They're from leftover yarn. Very squishy. So, that's already one finished object. Second finished object, it's also a pair of socks. My frozen self-dyed yarn, variegated. And I also have two of these. I would have had a third pair of socks done, but unfortunately, I lost my project bag in the Edimburgh yarn. At the Edimburgh Yarn Festival at the airport on the way back. I don't know if it was stolen or dropped it or something else. It was with one of my self-dyed, self-striping yarns that I showed to you a few last episode. Yeah, I showed it last episode to you, I believe. In the colorway, very British. They were really beautiful. Unfortunately, I lost them and I cannot show them. They were with needles and notions pouch and everything in the project bag as I lost them. I have another finished object which was, well, it was on the hook. It is a crochet project since 2 years, and I only had like half a sleeve to do on it, and I've done it and even had it with me at the Yarn Festival. And that is this very chunky cardigan in simple double crochet, raglan top down. It is huge, sorry. And I only had like so much sleeve to do and never did it. Well, until now, it is big, as you can see. But it fits me. It's a really chunky, loose cardigan. It was supposed to be for warming up in the hunting cabin or something like that. So, these are the finished objects. Let's go on. Well, first, I have to excuse myself for not wearing makeup or anything, but I have a very bad allergy at pollen. At the moment, everything is blooming and I'm getting the worst of it. So, I'm very sorry for that. Well, okay, let's go on. I have some works in progress. I have my granny stripe blanket, sorry, off camera, which got a lot of love. Sorry, the hook. I like to put my yarns in these big balls and then I just grab a ball and crochet it. This is where we are. Huge. I wouldn't fit in the camera. And last time I showed it, I was about here. So I did a whole big piece of it. I like this pooling. It turned out really pretty. And it's all true. Well, this is the big blanket, which is the granny stripe from the sock crest, granny striped on 3.5 millimeter hook. I have, this is a clover. Clover. Look, I don't know, I just got a chip somewhere. So, this goes back into the big box. It's living at the moment. And I started yesterday a pair of socks. Not my normal pair of socks. I usually do my socks on DPNs. I love my Zings from Knit Pro. I had the lost ones were on a pair of symphonies from knit pro wooden because I'm not allowed to fly with metal needles. Well, they are brand new, first pair on them. I hope whoever finds them enjoys it. I called at the airport and, well, they could not help me. At least at the moment where I called, they haven't found it. So, my other work in progress, back on topic, is two at a time, magic loop. I have never made socks on magic loop. The yarn is the self-dyed. Well, this is quite accurate in the color. Yeah, this is quite accurate. It's called Easter. I showed it to you, I believe, as I had my big dye day. And I divided this into balls and keep it in this tiny cosmetic bag because it has to stay snug, not to twist around. And I'm doing them in the magic loop on 3 millimeter, 120 centimeter eddy needle metal. Very nice smooth join and then flexible cable. I really like them. So that's the second work in progress. I have done a few rows on my grain shawl by Tin Can Knits, but well, it's nothing to show. What else did I do? That's I believe all I did, because I was kind of stressed out with the whole going to Scotland. It was very, very stressful. I had to leave the clock like 2 o'clock in the morning and was all day on the way. I flew from Luxembourg. I'm coming to you from Germany, very close to Luxembourg. So I flew from Luxembourg to Amsterdam. I changed planes in Amsterdam. I had a 2-hour break in there and changed planes and flew on to Edinburgh. And I have never been in there, so alone on the road. But it was funny. I met a lot of nice knitters. Very nice people. Hello to you all, if you're watching. And then I had my first day in Edinburgh was touristy. Did all the tourist stuff. Visited the city. Well, the Royal Mile, up and down. I lived on the Royal Mile, which is the tourist street in Edinburgh. And then my second day in there, I was at the yarn festival, which was okay. It was small in my opinion for all the promotion they did. We had a few months ago in Luxembourg the creative exhibition, which was not so much promoted, but and it was not only knitting related, but they definitely had more exhibitors in a bigger space and everything. As from this point of view, disappointed from Edinburgh because it was tiny, dark, much too overcrowded, and no fresh air in this corn exchange hall. It was really dark and then stuffy and that's it, sorry. And the light was bad, you could not see really the colors. You were holding yarn in your hands and hoping it is what you imagined it to be, because really recognizing a color, well, some had some own lighting, some didn't, and then even the lighting was sometimes colder or yellowisher, and it was difficult. I met some very nice people, like I said, and I would like to greet you all. Hi. It was very nice. Everybody was friendly, and then that was the positive part of it. A lot of knitters. You were just walking down the street and then saw people in hand knits, and then you were just greeting them and they greeted you back, and then sitting in cafes and just knitting on my socks, which I lost. And there are people coming by and saying, hi, are you at the Yarn Festival? Or stuff like that. That was nice. And also, very beautiful hand knits. I'm not advanced enough to start thinking about the cardigans that I saw or stuff like that. But that was a positive. Very friendly, very nice, open, and then I met people from all over the world. I met some of my... I went fangirl on some of my favorite podcasters. Sorry. But I also met some new people. Which was totally funny because you just met people on the street and start talking to them, and then I consider some of them friends meanwhile. So, enough of the yada yada. Let's start with a haul. There is a big haul. Not as big as I would have liked, because some of the yarns that looked pretty in catalogs or internet, well, they turned out to be quite scratchy and then not only rustic, but really nothing that I would turn to garments because you could not wear them. So, we start with a small part of the haul. I was gifted this. This is a sheep that says, "Knit happens," which I find very sweet. I'm gonna hang it in there on one of the knobs. I love it. So, a sheep, "Knit happens," and it does. So, I was gifted this. And then I got, I have some from the knitting gift shop. They had a huge amount of gifts for knitters and crocheters online. They didn't have so many products with them at the exhibition, but I did find this. This is a needle gauge in millimeters in cat shape. I love cats. I don't have any, but I love it. So that's it. Wait, like this. And it goes from 3 millimeters to 10, if I'm not wrong. I found it very pretty. It's wooden and it's pretty. And this was from the knitting gift shop. It was almost £5, so it was not cheap, but it's pretty. It's a kitty, I could not let it. Then, what I also got, it was not from the exhibition, but it is from Edinburgh. I got some earrings, which I'm gonna turn into project keepers and stitch markers. Wait, let me separate them a little bit. I'm gonna use this. I got this Murano glass type in blues. This is a single one. And then I got this strawberry, which is also a single one. It's pretty. And then I got a pair of, ice cream cones, which I just love. Yes, I have yellow, 3 balls of ice cream. They're very pretty. These were expensive. They were like £6, 2 of them. So I consider that expensive for just turning them into project keepers. Then I got 2 slices of cake, they're kind of stuck. Oops, one fell. Hang in there, see? And it has a cherry on top and then some biscuit. There are 2 of them. They are also like 6-7 pounds the pair. And then I got 2 pairs of these brown socks. They are only £4 a pair, but I thought it made the most beautiful project keepers. They are just gorgeous. Wait, do you see them like that? They're brown with points and then contrasting heels and toes. 2 pairs of those I got. They were, I believe, £4 each. And then I had also to get a pair of, that's the same. Where's the other one? Here. Sorry. This is the other pair of socks that I got. They are like that. They are pinky. And, well, I'm girly. I like pink. They're pretty. So, these are gonna turn to be stitch markers and project keepers. And now it's gonna come a big bag. Sorry. Have them in a tin. I had to close it. So those were the tiny things. I found them in a very fancy little shop. They were funny people in there. and I loved it. They had all kinds of stuff, but this is what interested me and what I got. What I also got, I love thrift shops, and I went on my free day when I was not at the festival in some of them and got some pattern books. Wait, let's start. I got Golden Hands. I like vintage mitts. And mitts bright and warm. So, then I got this crochet, also from Golden Hands. Very pretty patterns inside. Yeah, cheap. And then I got this one. And cross-stitching. And then I got, wait, here are some other ones. This is a single pattern, which I liked. This is very, this Aran, which they had in there a lot. You could buy it souvenir shop, but they were all machine made. Then I have this Aran book, which has a few patterns in it. And I got this book, Vogue Knit, number 102. Which I believe was published, let me see, does it say one? It looks from the inside very, very vintage. When were it published? Okay, let's see from the back. I didn't find the date. It should have it somewhere. Vogue Knit number 102. It really does not have a date in it, but it is very vintage. Okay, wait. Printed Great Britain. It does not say when it was made, but it is very vintage and it has very vintage patterns in it. Black and white, all of it. Some old promotions, but I love this one. And then I got Bernard Baby Blankets. It was only 15 pence, so could not leave it. Then I got this roll for £1. Which also has some great patterns in it. And this one. This one was £3. It's called Ember. 21 pieces. Which has also very Scottish patterns, in my opinion. Well, I hope to one day to be able to do such stuff. I'm just a new knitter, so this one I also got, also for £3, Malabrigo, number book 4. Pretty, I really like it, but also very complicated, at least in my opinion. Some color work, some cardigans, some hats, some scarves, fancy socks. It is one which I don't get in Germany, so why not? £3 is not much. And at the airport, I still had some pounds left. And decided, I believe that's why I lost my pouch. To spend them and not change them back. It was not much, it was just like 10, 12 pounds. So I got this. Very easy, from what I flew through it on the plane. I guess I would be able to make all of them. I was very interested in these socks, but, well, they have a seam on the sole, which, it's in my opinion, it's not good to step on. They have very sensitive feet, so I will probably never do them. That's the bookie. Should I start with the yarn? Okay, I'm bringing my yarn up. It's still in the backpack, most of it. Get the socks out of the way. I showed them to you. So, the first two balls are these two ones. They are 100% Scottish wool, if I'm not wrong. Incredibly scratchy, but I had to get something Scottish. I like the colors, but I don't know if they will become socks or something, because they are very rustic. I don't know if you realized it on the photo. I love the colors. The colors are quite true on my iPad. I like the green. And if I'm not wrong, they are from them. They are like £7.99, if I'm not wrong, pounds a ball. They look pretty, but they're incredibly scratchy, I'm sorry. And then I got yarn. So I'm gonna dig some of it out because it's in groups. How is it? This three. So I got from Phileas yarn. Sorry, this kind of got, this is where you find them. Got bumped up. I was backpacking. And I got this one. I don't know if I'm gonna make a hitchhiker scarf out of it or not. It is, what's the content? 80% merino, 24% nylon. I love the colors. I love blue and teals. Then I got from Dye Ninja High Twist merino fingering, 100% merino wool, in the colorway Calypso. And also this three in DK. It's also from Dye Ninja, which are gonna become a scarf together. And this is so squishy. Oh, I love this yarn. And well, I wanted to have this five pair of sparkly sock yarn, which I didn't find. I found some, but the sparkly was very loose spun in, and it had kind of like antennas, which, well, that's not something I wanted on my socks. So I got this. Yeah, I love hedgehog fibers. I got the bluish one. With purples and browns. Here again. And this, Salty Tails and grays. And the light one, which is Brumble. Pretty. And from Aiden Cottage. They had very nice yarns, but bloody expensive, excuse my way of this expression. And I wanted two sweater quantities, and everywhere they were like, yarn that I will get in Germany for half the price. It was in there incredibly expensive, like Woolmeiser was there were some other ones, some German ones, which were so expensive that I decided, well, it's not worth it. Just to be able to say I got it in there, I'm not gonna pay the double price for it, because, well, if I get it for half the price in Germany, then I should get it here. So I got the sweater's quantity, which was even at a quite reasonable price from like I said, Eden Cottage. I got six skeins of these. It is 100% baby alpaca in DK weight. It is very squishy and everything, and it was like 11 pounds or 12. One skein. And I have a whole bunch of them, like six. I believe there are six. The lady said I would need five, but I kind of said, well, let's take six, be sure. They ship to Germany, but shipping, it's so expensive, and just for one skein it would be like 20 or 30 pounds, so I decided to get enough for a sweater. And I'm gonna try to knit a sweater out of it, which is gonna be a funny thing. I don't wanna destroy the yarn, but pretty. And this is really so cuddly. I love it. It's like, you cannot compare the two of them. This is really, And then this, get it in there. It's pretty. And then I'm gonna put it back in my backpack because I don't have any space for it yet. And I'm still storing my haul in the backpack. I unpacked all the other stuff which I had with me. But the yarn I put back because, well, where should I store it? I have to make some space. Well, I believe that at the moment I have enough yarn for 10 lifetimes. A few months ago I did a big cleanup and I had lots of acrylic. Like 2 years ago I crocheted and then knitted on my knitting machine a lot of hats for charity. And they had to be acrylic for washing and cooking and disinfecting. And I still had a lot of it left over. But I decided to be a little bit egoistical on my knitting and knit more. I have a blister, so I'm gonna explain it later. And be a little bit more egoistical in my knitting and knit more for myself. And crochet for myself than for others. And I don't have a storage room for it, so I decided to give away a lot of it and gave it to some friends who are happy with it. The blister, you see it, yeah, it's in there. It used to be, it's just a tiny tag, skin tag left over. My socks which I had with me to Scotland, I started them at home on a pair of DPNs, but only 10 centimeters because I didn't have any other ones that were out of wooden, so I could take them on the plane. And I started them on these 10 centimeters, they're like this tiny. And the needle was at the other end, the opposite end, was poking me in the finger. And it was very uncomfortable. So the day before I left, I went to the store and bought a new pair of Knit Pro Symphonies, which I like it as interchangeable, but not as sock knitters. They're not slippery enough. Like I said, I usually use zings. I have a lot of zings, and it's also nice because the colors they fit. You have for each color, for each size, a different color, so you always know which belongs to whom. On the Symphony, usually there's a marking on them that goes away after the first pair of socks. You don't have it anymore, so I have to store them all together and not mix them up. Anyway, and then I got a new pair of Symphonies. I had them with me, and they're gone with a sock. And I really like that sock. It was even supposed to be a gift for somebody. Well, my best friend, she will not get them. She didn't know, so she's not gonna be sad about it. But they're gone. Like I said, it happens. Not to swear on a podcast, but Edinburgh was beautiful. Such a beautiful city. And the weather was great. We had sunny weather. Like, we don't have that weather here in Germany at the moment. It was blue sky, like May sky, I would call, Toscana sky. And people were all over, sitting outside and enjoying a coffee or a beer or whatever. And it was really beautiful. One day I was only 3 days in there, and on my last day we had a little bit of drizzly rain, but it was minimum. And I went to the Scottish Museum, visited Dolly, the cloned sheep. She looked like a normal sheep. But, well, she's badly stuffed, she has a hole. Beautiful museum, wonderful building. And what I found as a great thing is that the entry in the museum is for free. at least in my hometown, we have a big museum. It is the oldest city in Germany. We have lots of Roman ruins and then other stuff like that. Our museum costs money, even for kids. And they had in their, the normal museum was for free, and they had a special exhibition at the moment where kids were also for free, but grown-ups had to pay entry. But I liked the Celtic and the clan history and this part of the museum. That was very pretty. It is in a very modern building, which, well, it was not after my own taste because it was a little bit too fancy for a building. But the exhibited things were great. Very, very, very nice. I would like to go back to them. I still have something. I forgot it. I got something else. Woolly, but not knitted. Wait. I'm gonna be back in 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I'm back. Sorry. So, I saw this. There were all kind of touristy souvenir shops, and they had a lot of cheap made in China stuff, and I didn't want it. I have souvenir yarn, but I still wanted to get something. And there was this one shop, it looked really fancy from the outside, and they had their price tags on this. The thistle, this is the Scottish flower, everybody knows, but I liked this wooden thingy. And I went inside, believing you could buy it. I wanted to make a pin, a scarf pin, out of it. But it was not for sale. The lovely lady in the shop, as you can see, gifted me one. But it was actually not for sale. And then I found it really pretty. So, well, I cannot let the lady gift me just that without buying anything. And I have seen this shawl from the outside and liked it. It wasn't cheap because this was not from the touristy one. This is a really made. This is a brand from the shop. And this is a really made in Scotland, made in Edinburgh, from Scottish wool scarf. I like this pattern. But most of all, I like my stags. And this is double. This is held double. So, it is woven, but I definitely like this pattern. So, I got this for myself as a souvenir. It doesn't look good, and it's much too warm in here. So, I believe that's it. Finished objects, works in progress, haul, lost socks. If anybody finds this pouch, but in red, with a pair of started socks in my favorite British colorway, red, black, beige, on DPNs from Knit Pro, with a tiny Notions pouch in an old coin purse, somewhere in Edinburgh Airport, please knit them on. Don't unravel them. Finish the socks, keep them for yourself. I'm sad for losing them, but I would be happy to know that they found some happy feet of their own. So, I believe that's it for today. Not a lot of knitting due, even though there are almost 2 weeks since the last podcast, but I was very stressed out with work before leaving, and now I'm back and I'm stressed out again. I finished the socks. I finished the cardigan. Well, I found it. The funny part is, I found the cardigan while I was hiding all my yarn before the trip, so my husband won't get angry when I come back and he was alone with all my yarn. And finished the cardigan, did a lot of my blanket on my blanket. Well, that's it. Nothing new. I really do love my scarf, and I believe this is gonna be my new slogan, Knit Happens. So, I hope to see you again in 2 weeks, because I decided to make this only twice a month, I'm too slow with doing my hand knits. And see you then. Hopefully with better weather. So knit on, knit happens. Bye bye.